Okay, so now we're using iCloud as your main cloud storage system. The next question is, how do you share documents? Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Apple. My name is Carl Pullein, and in this week's episode, I'm going to show you how to share documents using your iPhone and also using your Mac. Now, the thing is, I would love to be able to show you how to share documents. And back in June, when we had the WWDC, and Apple announced iOS 13 and Catalina, that was what we were meant to be able to do. Sadly, that didn't ship in the finished version. We are expecting to be able to share files, that is the folders within your iCloud, next year, hopefully sometime in the first quarter. But that said, we can still share individual documents, and that is what I'm going to show you how to do in this week's episode. And it's not quite as simple as you might think. Anyway, before we go any further, if you do get any value from this episode, then I would be most grateful if you would hit that like button. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel and you would like to get lots of tips and tricks on using your iOS devices as well as your Mac, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you into iCloud so that I can show you how to share your documents. Okay, so here on the desktop, and this is where we're going to start, I have a number of files. And if you watched the first episode of Working with iCloud, you will have seen these files. Nothing's changed. This is just my demo account. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my personal files, and I have one here already set up. Now you'll see that it's already shared by me. That's because I've been testing to make sure that it works. And essentially what you do is you can now tap on that and you can go to this button here, share the selected items. Now remember, this is actually on my computer. I'm not on the web. You can go to the iCloud.com and share from there. But I've always found that this, when you're on your Mac, is a much quicker and easier way to do it. So you go from here and you can go on to there. Now, what it's going to give you is a number of options. Now, I've always found that this is not necessarily the best way to do it. What I find is the best way to do it is to go control click and go down to share. And you've got exactly the same actually from there. But sometimes you do get other options. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add show people, and it's going to show me that the only person at the moment that has got the link is obviously myself. This is I am the owner. So when you get to this part, all you can do is you can go here, click on that, and now you can share. So who can access? Anyone with the link, only people you invite, which means you have to send them an email to an email address, and they would have to log in using that email. And then you have an option here where view only or can make changes. So let's say you're collaborating with a team, then can make changes. If you're not collaborating with a team and you just want them to look at the file, then view only. So anyone with the link, that's the one that I'm more interested in, because this is just for me, it's just much easier. And then you click on copy link or send link. It's entirely up to you. Now at the moment I'm sharing this, so I can choose to say stop sharing. I'm not sharing it with anyone, I was just testing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to copy the link, and then I can click done. Now the thing is, where's it gone? So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go into my notes. I prepared a note earlier, so let's just go into the note here. And what I can do is, this is a screencast, I'll just as the title, and then I can just command V, and it will give me the actual email address. And when I click on that, now it will open up in ScreenFlow, because it's actually telling me ScreenFlow, which is the app that I use, which is really cool because it will automatically detect the type of file that it is. And that's one of the beauties of iCloud for sharing documents. If you have the actual file application on your computer, it will automatically open. It won't necessarily download something and then you've got to double click. It does save you a lot of time. So let's go back to this one here. So if you can do the same from here, if I click on this, I can now show people, And again, I can share option links, send link, done, whatever. So if I click on send link, so instead of copy link, if I click on send link, it's now going to ask me how I want to share that. So if I want to share that by copy link, which I just did, or I want to add it to Todoist or OneNote, which is really kind of interesting, or I can just send it to mail. If I click on mail, it will open up my mail and then it will add the link automatically. So that's how you do it on the desktop. Now let's have a look how you would do this from your iPhone or indeed your iPad. It doesn't really matter. Both work the same way. Today, I'm going to show you how to do this on my iPhone. Okay, so here on my iPhone, I'm just going to go to my drives. I'm going to go to file. Now, what I want to show you is this is my real iPhone. Therefore, you'll see that I have 1.65 terabytes of space on iCloud because I'm actually using my main account. So I have a file here called new subscribers. And all I'm going to do is I'm just going to long press on that because I'm using an iPhone 11. And that will open up this option. I'm going to click on share right here, and it's going to give me a number of options that I would like to do. So I can just copy, I can show people, I can add tags. And by the way, that means that you can add tags from your iOS device. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click show people. Now I have, again, I've been testing this, so I've actually got this set up, but you've got the same thing. You can click on to share options. And again, anyone with the link can actually use this file and can make changes. So there we go. They can make changes or view only or only people you invite. Exactly the same as you get on the desktop. So that's when you go into share options. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on send link. So now it's giving me the options. How do I want to share this? And I have a few options here. I can copy the link again there. So I can copy that link and it's going to copy the link for me. Okay, that's fair enough. But what I wanted to do is just show you how you get the link. So again, I can say send link. So it's going to give me up the options. And let's be honest, we're going to be sending that link somehow. So you can go into your mail, you can send it by messages. I'm just going to open this up in drafts because this is just easy. And there you go. There's the link. It's actually done there. I can save it. I can open it. I can do whatever I want. But there you have the actual link straight to my iCloud that they can download these new subscribers. And for any of you thinking that you can actually just copy and paste that link or just type it out, why would you do that? That file has already disappeared, so don't worry, it's not there. So anyway, that's just what I wanted to show you. So I'll just go back into that so that you follow me. So all you do is long press on the document you want to share. You can hit on info, you can click quick look, whatever you want to do. I'm going to click on share. It gives me the options. I can share it with people that I've actually contacted recently. I can also share it directly to my desktop, which I call Tana. And I can just copy the link, done. And I can then open that in. Actually, that's something I didn't test, but it was test. No, it doesn't work like that. I don't know why it says copy, because you can't copy the link. So go into share, and you want to go show people. I find that's the easiest way, show people, and then send link, and then you have the options that you can send it whichever way that you want from there. So there you go. Now, as I mentioned in the introduction, Apple did promise in iOS 13 that we would get to be able to share files, well, folders. Well, we're not able to do that yet. The rumor is that will come early next year. When that comes, I will update this video. But hopefully you've got something from this. What just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you have enjoyed these Apple videos that I'm doing, and you want to build your very own Apple productivity system, then please check out my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course, which is available from my Learning Center and is incredible value. And it will show you how to bring all these parts together, the Notes app, iCloud, Reminders, and Calendar into one beautiful productivity system. Check out the course here. The details are below, and I hope to see you in the course.